Hello everyone. In this video, I will explain how to automatically populate a PowerPoint presentation with data from a SharePoint list using Plumsail processes and Power Automate. In case you're not familiar with Plumsail, processes are a Plumsail Documents feature with an intuitive interface for creating documents from templates. Stay tuned. For our example and for the purpose of this video, we will generate a PowerPoint project report using just data pulled from the SharePoint list. This is how our list looks like. We have different columns like project name, project type, description, priority, status, and project manager name. Our goal is to create a presentation that will include data for each item in the list. One item will be presented per slide in the final presentation. Our next step would be to switch to our Plumsail account. If you don't have a Plumsail account, you can register to start configuring the process. We offer 1 month free trial for you just to test and explore our products. So now what we have to do is to create a new process. To do that, go to the processes section in your Plumsail account and click add process. In here we have two options. Start from the template and start from blank. In our case, we will start from the blank and give our process name as a template type, select PPTX, PowerPoint presentation template, and click next to proceed. The next step is to configure our template, and there are two internal steps that will guide you through configuration, editor and settings. The editor mode allows you to build the template from scratch or upload a pre-made one. We will choose this option to upload a new template which we already created. In our template, we can see tokens placed in double curly brackets. They are special placeholders that will be replaced with real data dynamically. I can also use nested tokens with a dot operator to refer to various properties of the projects. Our templating engine is smart enough, and when it receives data array, it will iterate through all the projects in the array to render them and add slides automatically. In here we can see if we are not happy with the template, we can also edit it online. In this case, I'm happy how everything looks and we'll click save and next. In settings, we can choose the template mode to be testing or production mode and give our output file name. And also we can use tokens, which I mentioned earlier, just to populate file name dynamically. I will add a date token in here just to get the date dynamically. Next, I choose the output file name type as PPTX. There are some other advanced options which you can explore. Next step is to add delivery. In here, we can see many options. For this demonstration, we will deliver our results to SharePoint library. Next, what we have to do is to connect to our site, select the desired library and folder, where the outcome document will be saved. We will type in our folder name and click save and next. We can also use tokens to make this folder name unique. And we have finished the Plumsail process setup. And now we have to create a flow with Power Automate. And here we will create an instant cloud flow that will retrieve data from the SharePoint list and then run the process we created in the previous steps. In here, you can enter your flow name, and in this instance, we will select to be manually triggered. Add a new step and type get items action to get entries from our SharePoint list. Now we have to copy our site address from SharePoint and select the list name. Let's create an array that will contain all the data obtained from the get items action. Enter a variable name and select the array type for it. Apply to each control loops through an array of items and it performs an action on each of those items. Now we'll add an append to array variable action and fill it with dynamic data from our SharePoint list. In order to build a JSON object, we have to match token names with output from the get the items action just to be able to pass this array to presentation template in the later steps. Finally, let's add an action that will trigger the created process. Action name start documents generation process with JSON is an action from the Plumsail Documents connector. If this is your first time using the Plumsail Documents connector, Power Automate will request the connection name and API key. Now we can go back to our Plumsail account to add a new API key. In here you can generate it, give it a name, and copy the key and paste it. You will need to select the process you created in the process name field and specify JSON data in the template table field, and you have to save this. And we are all set to create presentation from SharePoint list. We can click to My Flows and run our project management flow by pressing the play button. Then run flow and done. If we go back to SharePoint and select documents, open our presentations folder, and here's an example of our output document. As you can see, all fields are automatically populated from our SharePoint list. Also, you can notice for each SharePoint list item, we've got a separate slide. This is very useful if you need to save time creating PowerPoint presentation for project reports. That was all for this video. I hope you find it useful. And if you are struggling with the repetitive document-related tasks in your organization, please feel free to share your case in the comment section, and we will consider demonstrating how it can be done and automated in future videos. Also, you can try Plumsail Documents for free for 30 days, no credit card required. Thank you.